Yes, teams on 10 back again. It's going to be a big one. We're going to park the COVID misery for just a while and have a good laugh. Isaac Quaynor to join us. Yes, it is teams on 10. Nick Butler alongside the former Blue and Giant and now the Christian Petrarca of social media, Dylan Buckley. How are you, my friend?
Nick, I'm great. Thanks for having me. It's always a pleasure.
All right, what got the juices just ticking over the weekend?
Lots. The juices were well and truly flowing over the weekend, but something that took my eye, again, I love the young blokes coming through in our game, Cody Waitman from the Western Bulldogs. Gee whiz, he was fantastic on the weekend. Now, there's not many better players that have kicked a better goal and a better mark than this in their first game. That is absolutely fantastic. But he was hard at the footy too. He was giving it to Mick Hurley. He was giving it to all the Essendon players. I absolutely loved him.
Bit of spunk about the boy and good genes like you, the nephew of Flea Waitman, the Richmond champion. And you know the best thing about young Cody? He wanted to be a footballer since he was knee-high to a grasshopper. Apparently every time he got a bag of chips as a kid, he bought the Wish chips and wished to be a footballer.
I did say that.
I wish to be a footballer too.
Did you get the chips or...?
No, I just wasn't that good. On to my... Can I do mine?
Sure, please.
Joshie Walker. Now, why does this man keep getting the flick? I don't know, because in my mind, he's a gun player. He's got some feather issues. He's a bit light on top with the follicles, but they're growing back, and our people at Mosh will be contacting Joshie. And as the feathers come back, I think his form will come back. Look at that big hanger he took. And it wasn't just that big disco roach mark. Look at that. That is an all-time corker. But he just kept flying for them. And Benny Brown isn't really firing a shot. And I like that Joshie Walker is a big man with thinning hair that keeps flying for the marks.
He's playing some really good footy. I absolutely love Josh Walker. I think he spent a bit of time up at Brisbane as well as the Cats. So he's been around. But it might all click for him down at North, as you said. Ben Brown's been a bit quiet. But big Joshie Walker, he might be taking over.
So as I said, our people are talking to the Mosh people and we're just going to thicken up the hair because we're all going to get on nice and early, a bit of a preventative attack on the Mosh. Just good to see a guy that consistently goes for his marks. Agree?
Agree. Now, I know this is what gets your juices flowing, but something is getting my juices stopping.
Draining your juice.
It's draining my juice. And that is the issue of socks in footy. Now, socks are meant to be worn up or down. And I think that there's only one way to go about this. It's up or down. And something that's really frustrating me, Nick, is players that are wearing their socks in the middle of their shins. Now,
middle socking.
Okay, Patrick Cripps, bad example, because he can do whatever he wants. Yeah. But there's some people out there in the AFL that are wearing their socks in the middle of their shin, and it is really starting to frustrate me. It's been a thing that I've thought about for years.
Brucey,
there again, is fantastic player. Up or down, Brucey? I want him up or down.
Is this calf tat related?
Oh, look, there's a lot of calf tats getting around the AFL. I wouldn't say it's calf tat related, but I think it obviously exemplifies when they have got the calf tat because you notice it a little bit more. But, yeah, it's just the indecision of some of these guys. I just cannot cop the half sock.
Perplexed by this. You notice weird things about footy, and I think that's why I like working with you, because most of the high-paid analysts, they're not looking at half socks.
We tackle the big issues.
Attack on the ball and disposal efficiency and extras at the contest and all that rubbish, but you look at half socks.
Half socks is a big issue in footy, and I think that it's been a long time that it's been going unscathed. So I'm hoping that next weekend we can see some guys with some socks down or up, and we'll highlight that and show the fans.
Stamp that out. Okay, I mentioned Joshie Walker's feathers before, and I'm on the feathers at the moment. We've had some email correspondence, and I'll just get this right. It is from dothesheik@hotmail.com, and he's a Carlton man, and he's emailed me through one of your early media performances at the Blues. It might have been the first time, as a young man, you're about 15, you spoke to the Carlton family, and I think we can roll the pictures very soon. The feathers you decided to rock are quite offensive.
Wow.
What is that?
Sure. Captain of the Metro.
And let's have a listen to you as well.
16th.
Let's have a listen to the delivery.
We played up in Bankstown in the National Carnival up there, and we did all right and just played the rest of the states of WA, SA and South Australia. So, yeah, it was a really good experience.
Okay, so
South Australia and SA. I've mucked that up.
Double stated. Oh, look, you're a cute young kid, but what's going on with the feathers? And also, did you think you were going to the Torquay pub for a couple of beers afterwards? What's with the low-cut Henley?
That's embarrassing, Nick. And, that's on the internet forever, unfortunately. But There was a club back in the day that I was obsessed with, and I think a lot of people from Melbourne would remember the one called Wawa Lounge. And there was the fringe back then was very, very cool to have a fringe like that. And I put a lot of work into that. I put a lot of work into that fringe, and I was absolutely thought I'd killed it. But looking back now, I definitely wasn't. That was really embarrassing.
How long before one of the senior players or the coaches said, young fella, get rid of the weird side fringe?
That was cool. That was cool back in the day. It probably didn't help me get a game for 3 years, and that might have been something that was holding me back.
Very debatable whether that was cool. One player that is cool, and he's starting to make a name for himself at the Magpies, is young Isaac Quaynor. He's been in some ripping form, and so have Collingwood. Isaac, thank you for joining us on Teams on 10. Life must be pretty good in the WA hub.
Yeah, I think at the moment we're in a pretty good space. Obviously, enjoying life up here in Joondalup at the resort. So, obviously, got a pretty cool setup here, playing some really good football, and the boys are all really enjoying it. So, it's pretty positive vibes around the club at the moment, which is good.
Now, you've had one of our favourites on this show, Travis Varco, down in defence with you. How much of a thrill has that been, and have you learned anything from the very aggressive two-time Cats Premiership player?
Yeah, I'm loving seeing him back down there. He's been really good. And then actually for me, he's been a bit of a mentor, obviously quite an experienced player in the AFL system. So he's been really good for me, just instilling a lot of confidence in me and backing my strengths in as well. So yeah, he's kind of been driving all that physicality, and it kind of makes you want to be as physical as him and kind of drive that as well.
Travis Varco, absolute superstar. He actually punched me in the sternum one day, and I'm still recovering from that, but we'll move on. Isaac, you're playing some great footy at the moment, mate. It's reminding me of actually my own highlights back in circa 2015. There's a lot of similarities. Have you been watching some of my clips?
Yeah, well, I may have taken a leaf out of your book. I don't know. I've been trying to show the speed, and I guess trying to play with a bit of X factor. So I think maybe that's taken a bit out of your game.
Mate, isolation hubs at the moment. We touched on it earlier. It's a tough time, but we all know there's players out there you just do not want a room with. Is there anyone out there that with Collingwood at the moment that you're really struggling and you wouldn't want to be teamed up with?
Well, the player that I would probably choose is Cal Brown. He is just a pain in the ass, he's a full-on character, and I think if I was in a room with him for however long it might be, I'd probably end up punching him in the head. So I'd say he'd probably be the person, but we're actually pretty lucky. We've all got our own rooms.
Mate, you're living the good life there at Collingwood. I remember playing some NEFL footy. We used to be in the dorms down there, maybe sometimes some hostels. So that's fantastic to hear you got your own room. Looking at my career, I suppose there was always some times that, you know, as a player in defence, there was times where you're taken to the goal square. Maybe some teams tried to isolate you. Mm-hmm. Have you had any hard times like that coming in your career so far?
Oh, look, I've played on some pretty big-name players for, like, small moments of the game, like, obviously playing on Gary Ablett. I started on him when I came on. Obviously he's a star of the competition and, you know, a really well-respected player. So even just being able to play on him was interesting, and he kind of was playing in that middle line. So just having to position myself in a way and kind of use my strengths to be able to kind of nullify his, I guess, in a sense.
Hey, Isaac, a bit of a weird one for you. I'm really interested about the bond you guys have got going at Collingwood, because you're a team of odd bods. There's blokes with sleeves and blokes with mullets, and then private school prefects all in the same line on the field, but you all seem to have great respect and be good mates. Can you shed some light on the bond you've got going down there?
Yeah, that's a good point. We are kind of a bit of a mixed bag, and blokes of different ages as well. Like, we got blokes with kids. There's almost, like, a few of the boys could almost be my dad. That's how old a few of the boys are. So I guess we all kind of just respect each other's differences. I think that's the biggest thing, and kind of have a lot of mutual respect between the 46 of us or 45 of us or whatever's on the list.
Mate, a quick one on the footy. Geordie DeGoey's finger, as viewers are all a bit shattered, because my word, that was a nice show to watch, him kicking five and doing all sorts of great things. How is he, and how much are you going to miss him?
Yeah, I had the locker next to him after the game, and I saw him obviously talking about his finger a bit, and it's pretty frustrating for him, and it's pretty sad as a Collingwood fan to see someone like Jordan Degoe go down with an injury that's going to put him out for an extended period of time.
And what a big test you've got this week up against West Coast. You've had the crowd on your side against the Cats. I reckon it's going to be 50-50 or less. So you're going to have to be on your game this weekend.
Yeah, definitely. Well, I got to play against West Coast in one of my four games that I played last year, and obviously got to feel the wrath of the Eagles fans, and it's pretty hostile in that stadium, especially when it's packed. It's a packed house, so I assume it'll be pretty similar this week.
Well, Isaac, you're quickly becoming one of our favourites. Thank you so much for giving us a bit of time on Teams on 10, and good luck this weekend.
No worries. Thanks, guys. Cheers.
Cheers to you. He is a player on the rise and I'm really enjoying his form. And Isaac will not need a car wash for a while because courtesy of Magic Hand Car Wash, he gets a 12-month unlimited wash club membership with Magic Car Wash at participating locations. Magic Wash Club is, Dylan, my friend.
It's cleaner, it's safer and it's faster.
That it is.
Now, Nick, I want to take over here because something that's taking storm with the young folk at the moment, which you would have no idea about, it's something called TikTok. You heard of it?
I saw Nathan Cleary doing a TikTok in the rugby league. Yep.
Anyway, I'm on TikTok. I went viral on the weekend with my TikTok. Check it out here. It's the unfortunate time in my career where this nearly ruined my life.
What is this?
I kicked a goal because I like
lid.
I love kicking them outside 50, but this one was a point and I was celebrating it. And I got trolled a long time for that. But the challenge and the reason I'm saying this is the AFL players in isolation hubs at the moment have been absolutely smashing TikTok. There's plenty of good content out there.
Yep.
And I know last week you challenged me if we lose a goal, the goal-kicking comp, to have a sing.
Yes, have a sing.
I want you...
Express yourself.
...when you lose to get on TikTok and do a dance for us.
Oh, I can move. So I had quite a good patch in the nightclub scene in about 2008 and I think I could replicate that form. So I'm a big man that can move a bit like a small man.
Yeah.
So challenge accepted.
Now, also something else that was big in the media at the moment is, yes, is my podcast.
On this, yes. Sorry, you've jogged my memory. Have you... So you have to sift through what's right and what's made up in the media sometimes. There is some rumours that you've put on a staff, like you've put a boy on. Is this true?
I can't deny that. I can't deny that at all, Nick. I have an intern that's helping me out with a few things now that he's very keen to get on board. So that's a story for another time. But I did have the famous and... best bloke I've met in footy, Zach Dawson,
very
on the show.
Very vulnerable man. He's got good stories because footy was a bit of a challenge. It didn't come easy like it does to Cripper. Zach seemed to have to fight for everything he achieved.
Yeah, for sure, and it was. And he copped a lot of criticism throughout his career and had a tough trot. But, he had a good chat on the show about some times that were quite funny. Check this out.
So I've jumped out the car. It's freezing cold. Freezing cold in the middle of winter.
Yeah.
Oh no, probably just about to start winter, and get out there, and the boys are just giving me the worst greasies, and I'm like, oh no, what's going to happen? So they get me at the front, absolutely tear shreds off me. I think Clarko gave me an absolute rocket. Tears. The tears.
I
didn't know what to do.
Oh no.
So my body was just like, just so disorientated. And like, it was like I was in shock. And the tears, like, I didn't know what else to do. And the tears
so
were like,
so this is in front of the whole team.
I was so sorry. Right? It was like the worst feeling that you could ever have. Being late to a late.
You're late to your own late punishment.
It's not. It is the bottom of the barrel. So that's where my... as part of my perception at the club, that really put it back a long way. And and even by the time I was delisted, like four years later,
that was still a thing?
Still a thing. It was always, you know, but by then I'd always get there early.
Oh, yeah.
And so I was always, once we went out to Waverley, I was driving from Keilor to Waverley. It was an even longer drive. Yeah, I'd get there early. If it's 7 o'clock, so I'd get there at 6 and I'd sleep in the car.
Mm.
Out of all that, you learn your lesson. But
a big lesson.
It was a very hard lesson to learn.
Gee whiz, Nick, crying in front of the boys is something that isn't great, especially when it's because you're late.
Crying's cool again. I think it's nice to talk about crying. I've got a couple of crying stories.
Yeah, look, we would love to hear them, but we actually don't have time because...
One?
Just quickly.
There was two. I got cut from the Vic Metro 16s, a team you captained when you played Adelaide and South Australia in the one carnival. Yep. Cried like a baby.
Yep. And I said one. I said one. We've got to get to another clip because this is something that does relate to you and it might have actually caused some tears. Zach actually reflects on the time he was playing a lot of twos-twos footy, which I know you play a lot of twos-twos footy. You dominated some two-two footy and he actually won the BNF at twos-twos. So let's take a look at that.
And so I spent a fair bit of time playing twos-twos.
The twos twos.
Yeah, I won the best and fairest in the twos twos.
The twos. So wait a second. So this is a
scoop. So the resi's resi.
This is a scoop because we love the twos twos on this show. There's nothing better than playing twos twos. You're saying that you're a pioneer.
I was kicking off to Jew at Box Hill.
At what 10 a.m.
It would have been 10 a.m. Arrive at 8 a.m. Up forward, kicking bags.
In the twos twos.
In the twos twos, and won the goal kicking BNF in my first year.
That is something he should be very proud of,
exactly.
Winning the goal kick in the BNF in the twos twos. I think that it's the twos twos, twos twos getting cool again.
It is cool. It's definitely cool to be in the twos twos. You would know all about that.
One thing that's always been pretty cool in footy is that ability to suck up all your bravery and go back with the flight of the ball.
Definitely.
And I must say that the boys took their courage pills over the weekends. There were some absolute rippers. Have a look at that, Sam.
That's
Walsh,
incredible. That's mark of the year.
Back where angels fear to tread. And young Mackesy as well. That is a straight liner. That's Revolt and Jonathan Brown. Really good. There was one that went wrong. Young Hayden from the Kangas. Wow. My goodness, that didn't work out well for the young fella. That is just bloodline bravery. What I wanted to say here is a tweet caught my eye from a good mate of yours, Xavier Ellis, doing really good things. Fine footballer for start and doing really good things in the media over in the West. What a position to find yourself. Pull out and you're trolled on social media and highlighted on TV programs. Don't and get effed up with unknown future consequences. Sheesh.
Now, quickly, that is a sheesh at the end, not a shush. But Davey's got a point. I think it's a good point. As you go into a game, especially at the end of my career, I was always thinking you have to go back with a flight in a game. And especially because you don't want to let your teammates down. Yep. You don't want to let your family down and be the bloke that doesn't put his head over it when he needs to.
But then what's that got to do with Twitter troll? My point here is you should be doing it for your coach and your teammate next to you and your dad maybe and your grandpa. You know, show that you've got the bravery to play. Not worry about Twitter trolls and TV flogs like us.
Yeah, no, exactly. I think that he meant that obviously your teammates are first and your coaches are first and you want to be respected and know that you do that in a game. But obviously on Twitter you don't want to get trolled as well. But there is a bit of vision that I do want to show you, Nick, and this is absolute bravery. Something that I'm not sure if you've had the courage to do this, but
a few times.
Circa 2015, we know this all too well, myself and Brett Delidio. Poor Jack Revolt. I think he's actually said that this nearly could have ended his career. He went on to win two flags. I'm not sure if that had something to do with it. It probably does. But gee whiz, that's a fantastic mark.
Producer Matt, are you able to roll my Mr. Clip mark of the day from the sample in 2000? No.
No, we don't want to do that. That's...
You're really dominating the show. Can I just say, things are becoming cool that weren't cool, like the twos twos and crying. What about, can we do a bit of a social call out for players that have had a bad moment and ducked the loaf a bit or turned and crumbed or just dropped one and it feels no good and everyone's pointing at you and the crowd are hooting. Do you think we could sort of get them and we'll cleanse the people and say it's okay? To do it. You're not a bad person.
It's definitely not okay to do it because I know a few times I've could have gone harder than I did. And it's definitely not okay, but we want to celebrate it.
Yep.
We want to celebrate it. We want to embrace it and move on. Maybe a bit of an intervention and just put it past yourself. So 10SportAU on Twitter and Instagram, Facebook. Send it in and we'll watch it on
hashtag
the clips, I think.
Turtlehead.
Turtleneck. Turtleneck.
That didn't work. Turtleneck.
It's a turtleneck. We want to show the vision and celebrate them, guys. Probably could have gone a little bit harder.
Okay, we're going to get to the hashtag turtleneck. And we've all done it. It's okay. It's okay. You shouldn't even get dropped for it, as long as you go hard the next time. On to the tips. I'm a bit rattled now.
Yep.
Suns and Dogs tomorrow night.
I'm going to go with the Dogs.
Giants Tigers grand final rematch. Are your Giants okay?
They are. They're fine. They're totally fine. People are panicking for no reason whatsoever. They will win this. They've won the last two at Giants Stadium against the Tigers.
Not going to play as individuals?
No, they will not.
Good to hear. Kangaroos Carlton.
Blues.
Sydney Hawthorn, very interesting game.
It will be. The Hawks will bounce back this week. Clarko, you never ever count him out. Nick, you know that. They will win this game comfortably, I think.
Like it. Port Adelaide, St Kilda. Port in hot form, St Kilda out of ISO in Noosa. That's very good for the mind. And striking some reasonable form against the Crows.
I think the Saints will win this game, Nick. I love the Saints at the moment. They're playing some good good footy. I absolutely love Bradley Hill. And not that I'm a big sports commentator, but I just don't think that Port will win the grand final.
Okay. Hello to our viewers over there at Alberton. Adelaide Essendon.
Essendon.
Eagles, Magpies, big game, and we discussed it with Isaac.
Yeah, we did. Isaac's one of my favourite players, but I think the Eagles will be too strong.
Melbourne, Brisbane.
Brisbane.
And to round things off on Monday night, Freo v Geelong.
Geelong.
Okay. Interesting round, and things are about to get crazy because your tips in the next few weeks when there's 45 games in 13 days are going to be all over the shop. But footy is a bit crazy at the moment. We're a bit crazy. What is that hashtag again? It's certainly not Turtle Head.
It's not a hashtag. It's at 10SportAU. That's what the handle is.
And for this stuff, though, your moment?
Just send it in.
Turtleneck. I think it's turtleneck. That was Teams on 10. We might be due for running the twos. Hope you enjoyed it. See you next week.